This video presents the enhanced stretch modifiers in ARCHICAD 22. The stretch zones from previous versions have been renamed to stretch modifiers. Let's see the changes of the new stretch modifiers through an example. Create a new profile via Profile Manager. Name it I Section. Now we insert a pre-drawn fill into the profile editor. Check the beam and column options in the Use With field. Please note, stretch modifiers only support profiled walls, beams, and columns. Save the changes by clicking on the Store Profile button. Create a beam on the floor plan and select it. Set it to the previous I section in the Structure field of the Info box. Let's create and open a cross-section through the beam. By opening the Beam Settings dialog, we can perceive that the width and height parameters have been grayed out in the element settings, so they cannot be edited. The stretch buttons are also not available in the PET palette when clicking the corner nodes of the profile in the section window. Let's return to the profile editor and check the width stretch and depth stretch modifiers checkboxes. Please note, horizontal and vertical stretch parameters have been renamed to width stretch and depth stretch modifiers. The size column shows the values of the default stretch. To show or hide stretch lines in profile editor, you can use the stretch modifiers control in the design layers panel. Let's store the profile and see the changes in the settings dialog. Now you can freely modify the beam height and beam width. You can edit their nominal values, and you can also get feedback via tooltip of both nominal and total values as well. Enter, for example, 400 millimeters for height and 200 millimeters for width, and click OK to see the changes in the section window. Click one of the corner nodes and use the Stretch Profile Nominal Width and then the Stretch Profile Nominal Height buttons in the PET palette to stretch the profile in both directions. As you can see, when stretching the profile, the web and flange thicknesses are distorted in proportion to the total size. To avoid it, return to the Profile Editor and drag the depth stretch lines to the inner edge of the profile flanges. In this case, only the middle, web part will be stretched instead of flange distortion. See the result in the section window. However, there is still a problem where the web will be distorted by horizontal stretching. Moving the vertical stretch modifiers cannot provide a solution for this. The perfect solution to the problem comes by the new offset modifiers. Let's see it in practice. Select the Steel Universal Selection profile in the Profile Manager. Here you can see that a flange thickness and a web thickness offset modifier have been defined in the Modifiers panel and in the Profile Editor. On the one hand, we can fix the value of web and flange at stretching, and we can give them individual thicknesses as well. Please note that you can watch detailed discussion of offset modifiers in a separate video. The stretch modifiers are located on the edges of the profile. Let's see in the section window how this profile works. Select the Steel Universal Selection profile in the Structure field of the Info box. You may notice that it is free to stretch and compress in both directions without web and flange distortions. Thanks to the enhanced offset modifiers, it is easier to customize the profiles, and the work becomes better with parametric modifiers.